Here I am, pulling another all-nighter. Editing videos can sometimes be a very tiring process where you feel like you're never going to finish that one freaking video. But I learned over the last couple of years that it doesn't have to be like this. Some of you might know that I used to work full-time for another YouTuber. When I started this job, I was pretty overwhelmed about how many videos need to be done each week. At some point, I had to edit 3 videos in only 5 days. I quickly realized that it's impossible to get such an amount of work done with the editing workflow I had at that time. I knew something needed to change. I improved my workflow in every single aspect to make it as efficient as I possibly could. And after months of optimizing, I was finally able to edit 10 times faster than before. Okay, I'm not sure if it was 10 times faster or 5 times faster, or maybe it was just twice as fast. I needed the clicks for the thumbnail, okay? Either way, I became a lot faster in editing over the past few years, and today I'm going to show you my top 5 tips on how you can also save hours on hours of time in the editing process. As some of you already know, I myself am using Premiere Pro to edit my videos, but the great thing about these tips is that they apply to any editing software. No matter if you edit in Premiere Pro, in Final Cut, DaVinci Resolve, Sony Vegas, or Windows Movie Maker. Okay, let's go. Before you even start with the edit, plan exactly which shots you need to capture and how they are going to work next to each other. Write a script, a shot list, or a storyboard. Here are the differences. A script defines the overall structure of a video and includes all the text passages which appear in the talking scenes or in the voiceover.
Check, check.
A shot list defines shot by shot what exactly needs to be captured in order to tell the script to its full potential, which is super helpful for both shooting and editing. In a storyboard, you visually draft the compositions of each shot so that everybody has a clear understanding of what it should look like. I never really do this, as I already know myself what my shots should look like, but it can be helpful if you work with other people who might not be able to imagine specific shots. It makes an incredible difference if you have an overall outline of what the video should look like, instead of starting with the edit and trying to build up a good story from some random shots. When I started with filmmaking, I just took videos of basically anything that looked good, and afterwards, in the edit, I tried to come up with some kind of story to combine these shots, which takes a massive amount of time. For my Paris travel video, for example, I didn't prepare anything beforehand, and that's why I spent months of looking through the footage, writing a voiceover that fits, and editing the final video. And if you plan your video beforehand, you not only save a massive amount of time, but your video is also going to be a whole lot better, as the main purpose of a script and a shot list is to tell the story in the best way possible. Trust me, I never really was a big fan of scripts, but as soon as you get into writing and using them for your videos, it will be a difference like day and night. So do it. Okay, so this is a pretty simple one. Get rid of anything that could distract you in your editing flow. Try to find a room where you are just by yourself. If you work in a shared office or at home with other people, buy yourself some noise cancelling or over-ear headphones. Turn your phone into airplane mode and put it somewhere where you can't reach it. Okay, maybe it's better to just put it upside down at the end of the table so that you don't look at it every time you get a notification. On your computer, close any programs which could possibly distract you, like WhatsApp, email, and so on. A high focus is super important if you want to edit efficiently. If you manage to drown out all the outside distractions, you will be able to quickly get into a mental state called flow, where you reach the peak of your concentration and productivity. It feels like some kind of tunnel vision, and your edit just flows instead of being disrupted all the time. So build up a discipline and get rid of any distractions. Okay, so now that you planned your edits and got rid of all the distractions, it's time to start with the actual edit. It's super important to have a simple but efficient folder structure when it comes to your projects. In this way, you are able to quickly navigate through all of the different files of your film project, and you never have to search for a specific clip, sound effect, or project. I developed a folder structure over the last years, which now works perfectly for me. Let's have a quick look at it. Okay, so here we have the overview of my video projects. Right now, I'm working on how to edit faster. My last video was the best POV setup. If you didn't watch it already, you can find it here. Basically, I have a default project up here, which is the one with the four zeros. And in there, you have three folders. The first one is projects. And in there are just all of the different editing projects. For me, it would be Premiere Pro, After Effects, Lightroom, and Photoshop. And within all of these folders, you can already see that there are already some project files in there. And that's because I already made templates for all of these programs. I'm going to talk about templates in a little bit. The next one is the footage folder, which is probably the most important one. In there, you have the videos, the audio, and the audio separates into music, sound effects, and the voiceovers. Then you have the graphics, which separates into still and motion graphics. So still are just, yeah, still standing graphics, and motion graphics are more like animations. And the last one is the photo, where I just throw in all of my photos, which I either use for Instagram posts or for my thumbnails. And in the last folder, you will find the output, where I put the actual renders of the videos and also of my photos. So yeah, it's as basic as that. I tried to keep the amount of folders as low as possible, and I found out that this works quite good for me. As I already said, it makes sense to create templates for your editing projects in which you already have a matching folder structure inside of them. In my case, I built projects for both Premiere Pro and After Effects. If you open the project, you will find different folders in the Explorer tab. The first three folders exactly match the folders of my footage folder, and in the other two folders, I already have some pre-built sequences for different resolutions and formats, and some other Premiere layers that I always use, like an adjustment layer or a simple background in my preferred color. In addition, I included different assets like my text animations or end card in a template, because I use them in every single project and I don't want to import them every single time. Templates like these save you a lot of time, because when you start your edit, everything is already prepared and you're ready to go. So you might still wonder how to actually use this folder structure, so I'm going to give you a quick walkthrough. First, I duplicate the default project. I change the name of the folder to a video number and the project name. In this way, I have a quick overview of my projects in the right order. I also change the names of the editing projects and sequences within them, in order for them to match. Then I import all of my footage for the project into the footage folder, and in the video section I create different folders for each camera I used. I drag the camera folders into the matching folder video in my editing software, where I now have a good overview and I'm ready to start editing. During the edit, every time you want to add other files to the project, always put them first in your footage folder and then import them to your editing software. If you import them from different locations, you will probably have problems to link the files as soon as you transfer the project to another drive. You can find a download link to my folder structure in the description below. Regarding the templates, they are only for Premiere Pro and After Effects, but you can easily build your own ones in your editing software. Just download it, play around with it, and adjust it to your needs. Staying organized with a good folder structure is an essential for a fast editing workflow. Also, in the case that you need to find a specific file from an old project, you immediately know where to find it. So yeah, get yourself a good folder structure. Almost any editing software gives you the option to assign your own keyboard shortcuts. I'm not exactly sure about Windows Movie Maker, but with all the other programs, you definitely can. With a shortcut, you basically assign a specific action, like making a cut, deleting a section, or picking a tool within the program to one key on your keyboard. And as you can imagine, this massively speeds up your workflow, because you don't always have to move your mouse to click on something, but you can just press one key and do the exact same thing. I mean, you're just so much faster at typing on a keyboard instead of moving your mouse and clicking all the time. I'm not going to go into detail on how to change your keyboard shortcuts, because there are plenty of detailed tutorials out there on YouTube. Just search for your editing software and shortcuts and you'll definitely find something. Oh, have to drink something. I myself have completely customized my keyboard shortcuts. I think almost no shortcut on it does the thing that it used to do in the standard settings. Many colleagues or friends always hate me for my shortcuts, because as soon as they want to show me something on my laptop, they just can't use the program in any way. But I actually put some deep thoughts into my shortcuts. They aren't just randomly assigned actions to keys, but there's a reason for it. I assigned them to be able to do every shortcut only with my left hand, so that with my right hand I can still use the mouse or, in my case, the trackpad. Now you probably think, oh my god, this amateur edits on a trackpad? What the f***? Here's the backstory. I used to use a mouse before, but then it stopped working and I just got used to edit on my trackpad, which actually has a really nice benefit to it because I can quickly edit on the go, as for example on airplanes or longer bus rides. Either way, with my shortcuts I can switch through all the different tools and do various actions with just my left hand. And I've been editing much faster since I changed them and got used to them. For everyone who's curious which Premiere Pro shortcuts I use, you can also find a download link to them below. If you don't like them, just delete them, but don't tell me that they're random or chaotic, okay? By the way, if you also often edit on the go like I do and don't always have access to a power supply, I have a recommendation for you. I myself edit on the MacBook Pro 16-inch, which actually has the biggest battery allowed on airplanes, but still, when I work on big editing projects, the battery of this thing is down to zero in less than 3 hours. So I was looking for a power bank with which I can charge my laptop to get some more work done on longer flights or bus rides, and I finally found one. It's called the OmniCharge Mobile 25600 Pro, and I can directly plug in a USB-C cable into it and then I connect it to my MacBook and it just charges like this. Obviously, you can also charge with normal USB-C ports, and it also has a DC port where you can choose between different voltages. The USB-C cable I use for this one is actually from a company called Nomad. So if you were also looking for a power bank like this, you can find the link to it in the description. They are affiliate links, so I get a small commission from them. But yeah, I just wanted to let you know because I had this issue for a long time and I finally found a solution. So that's why I wanted to share it with you. But now, let's get to the last tip. Let's go! Throughout the edit, you usually have to use many different files like sound effects, music, graphics, animations, and so on. If you have to search for these assets with every new video you do, you lose so much time and it's not fun at all. So build yourself a structured asset library where you always save new assets like sound effects, overlays, LUTs, and so on. In 99%, you will be able to use these files again in other projects, so it really helps to just have a place where you can always find a specific asset you need. Over the last years, I built up my own asset library, which is now more than 160 gigabytes large. In it, I have my own assets for this YouTube channel, like motion graphics, symbols, my end card, and so on, presets for different programs, animations and overlays, my own curated music library, a very large and detailed sound effects library, and different elements for photo editing. So when I am editing and, for example, I need a specific sound effect, I just go to my library, look for the sound effect and drag and drop it into my editing software, just as easy as that. And if you work with a library, you don't have to put all of these assets into your footage folder before importing them to your editing software, as I described earlier in my folder structure tip, because you save all of these new files into the library itself. I have my whole library saved on my internal computer storage so that I can easily link all the project files to the library if I open the project on another drive. If you constantly feed this library with new files and work with it on every project, you will immediately know where to find what you need without searching for hours on the internet and waiting for the download. Unfortunately, I can't give my whole library to you guys because I'm pretty sure that this would be illegal, so yeah, I'm sorry for that. By now, I actually feel like you can edit 10 times faster with those tips, as some of them are just insanely time efficient. Well, I hope you found some value in those tips and that you can boost your editing workflow to the limit. It takes some time to implement some of these changes into your workflow and get used to them, but if in the long term you save days or even years of time in front of your computer, I think it's 100% worth it. It was the first time I did a tutorial of this kind and I'm super curious about your opinion, so let me know in the comments how you liked it. Many of you guys already asked if I can do a tutorial on color grading, which I'm definitely going to do, but just give me some more time because I'm currently developing my own LUTs, which will make it a whole lot easier for you to achieve the same look as I do. And last but not least, also a huge thank you to my friend Patrizio, who allowed me to shoot this video in his beautiful studio today. He's also been helping me with the B-roll on my recent videos, and he also just started his own YouTube channel. So make sure to head over to his channel and check it out. You will find a link to it in the description below. If you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, feel free to do that, and also turn on notifications if you don't want to miss out on any of the upcoming videos. It's just the beginning, and I've got huge things planned for the months to come. So yeah, thanks for watching, guys, and I hope all of you have a great day. I'm gonna see you guys soon. Goodbye.
Oh, no. Alter, der haut aber auch drauf, ey.
Digga, es muss halt real kommen, Alter. Es tut fucking weh.